how to wake up earlier in the morning. The most valuable habit I've incorporated into my life has been waking up at 5 a.m. But why is waking up early the key to success? In the early morning, my canvas is still blank. It's before the colors of the morning commute run down my sides, and the sloppy brush strokes of emails and text messages find me. My canvas gets filled as the day goes on, and the window of possibility gets smaller. By the afternoon, I'm bleeding, heavy with half-dried paint. But in the pre-dawn darkness, everything is possible. Like starting a journey at the top of the mountain rather than the base, I am at my creative peak first thing in the morning. I am Corey McComb, and today I am a guest at Mr. Smart's YouTube channel. Subscribe to this channel to learn, improve, and succeed in life. Me at 5 a.m. I started waking up at 5 a.m. as a way to get a few hours of writing done before work. It didn't feel like I had enough hours in my day, so I created more. But now, 9 months in, I can say that waking up early is much more than another productivity hack. It's had a ripple effect that's touched all areas of my life and, simply put, made my life better. Here's why there are so many benefits of getting up early in the morning. 1. Discipline. Getting out of bed is difficult in general. It's doing the hard things first that sets the momentum for the entire day. Just by getting out of bed at an ungodly hour means you've won the first of many mental battles that are waiting for you. This discipline of getting up early in the morning is the root of all good habits. Cultivate it into your routine, and it'll be there when your motivation is still asleep. That's why I wake up at 5 a.m. every day. 2. A head start on the world. At 5 a.m., the sun is still asleep, and the moon is just finishing her shift. There is a strange sense of satisfaction knowing that your day is starting while most people are still in bed. It is exactly what makes 5 a.m. the best time to wake up in the morning. Whatever you do in the morning is up to you. Read, meditate, exercise, or just play. But knowing that you're up and ready ahead of the world has power. It's one of the reasons Kobe Bryant continued to be the first player on the floor for warm-ups long after he was established as the best player in the league. Being first holds psychological power. 3. Silence. It's easy to overlook just how hard silence is to come by until you actually find it. The sounds of the world will find you soon enough. But at dawn, we have more control over the volume around us. By all means, make 5 a.m. yours. Play music, watch TV, talk to yourself. Personally, the only sounds I want to hear at that time are the coffee machine bubbling and my fingers hitting the keys on my laptop. 4. No need to rush. When I wake up late, I have to get moving right away. It's shower, clothes, coffee, see you later. My mind is already focused on the day ahead before I even breathe the morning air. Just as the relaxed pace of early morning follows us throughout the day, the frenetic energy of feeling rushed sticks around as well. Are you convinced? Of course you are. Now, here's how to wake up at 5 a.m. every day. 1. Have a plan. Whether your aim is to increase productivity or not, you'll need a plan for the morning before your alarm goes off. Taking the guesswork out of the equation is always a good strategy for getting more done, but it's particularly important here since your sleepy little brain is going to try and bargain its way out of getting up. Knowing exactly what you're going to do once your feet hit the floor will give you a huge mental edge over the snooze button. This is how to wake up earlier in the morning. 2. Don't overthink. Want to know the best trick for waking up early? Set your alarm, and when it goes off, just get out of bed. If you give your brain a chance to ponder why you're getting up before the sun, it will talk you out of it. Just zombie walk towards the coffee machine, and it'll make sense eventually. 3. Work up to it. The first week or so will be hard to adjust, but like most things, consistency breeds simplicity. If you can't quit sleeping in cold turkey, try waking up 30 minutes earlier each day until you reach your target. If you want to be in the 5 a.m. club but normally rise at 8 a.m., this strategy will get you there by day 6. Whether you do it all at once or work up to it, it takes most humans 7 to 10 days in a row to adjust. It is how to wake up earlier day by day. 4. Go to bed early. As much as I'm a proponent of waking up early, I am a much bigger fan of getting enough sleep. Well, some people just need less sleep than others. Nonsense. You need 7 to 8 hours. Yes, you. The benefits of waking up early aren't worth much if you aren't getting enough sleep to function throughout the day. When life keeps me out until midnight or later, I push that alarm forward. That is how I wake up earlier and not feel tired. 5. For starters, it doesn't matter what you do. At least in the beginning, just waking up early is the goal. Once you make it a habit, you'll make good use of the early morning time. Maybe you read, write, or do yoga. Hey, maybe you wake up early and tag your friends in hilarious memes so they can have a laugh right when they wake up. Not all heroes wear capes. My fellows, don't forget to subscribe to this channel or visit the website MrSmart.org if you have found this video helpful. You can also join us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram through the links in the description. Live long, smart living.
My fellows, you will lead a happier, satisfied, and successful life when you follow the principles and life hacks mentioned in this animation. But we all tend to forget. 1 week or 1 month down the road, we shall forget the principles and rules that today we vow to stick to and follow. However, Mr. Smart has a solution for you in one word: repetition. Watch this video time and again. You've watched it today. You may watch it in 1 month from now, and then 3 months from now, and so on. And every time you watch the video, make an active self-analysis to track your trajectory of self-improvement. You can even keep a personal diary to note your observations. Live long, smart living.